You notice that you're getting up more frequently at night to go to the toilet to pee. Does it take you a longer period of time to pee and empty your bladder? Are you going more frequently in the daytime? Is it a bit of a trickle or gravity fed? If you've answered yes to any of these questions, it is possible that you could be suffering from a benign enlargement to your prostate, or BPH. Hi, my name is Dr. Charles Chabert. I'm a urologist and I'm a director of the prostate clinic. The following video is here to highlight and to explain for you a really common condition that affects men as they progress through life, namely BPH, or benign prostatic hyperplasia.
This model highlights some of the anatomical considerations to be aware of. Bladder above, pubic bone below, and here's the prostate. In essence, the prostate is shaped like a donut in that there is a central cavity through which passes the urethra. The urethra is the outlet pipe of the bladder. There are several zones inside the prostate, two of which you need to be aware of. This central part here is called the transition zone, and this is the area of the prostate that is prone to BPH. The cells within this area multiply gradually and progressively through life and take up more and more space. It acts a little bit like a clamp on the pipe and causes urinary symptoms. The outer part of the prostate is away from the pipe, and it's this area, or the peripheral zone, where the majority of prostate cancers arise from. The following image highlights a sagittal view of a multiparametric MRI taken of an individual with significant urinary symptoms. Highlighted by the cursor is a very large intravesical median lobe. That is part of the prostate that has grown extensively into the bladder, causing an obstruction. The pelvic floor is at the base of the image. We can also see that the bladder wall is thickened, and this happens in individuals with chronic bladder outlet obstruction.
BPH is very uncommon the younger a man is, and it doesn't increase in frequency and become clinically relevant for the majority of people until men progress beyond the age of 40. A man is 80 years of age, around 80% of men in that age bracket will have some evidence, some histological evidence of BPH. As there is progressive and gradual obstruction to the outlet pipe of the bladder, there is the development of urinary symptoms. We characterize urinary symptoms into two main categories: those that are related to the obstruction of the bladder and those that are related to storage of the urine, or irritative symptoms. As there is progressive obstruction to the bladder, the flow, or the pressure a man generates, will be slower. It can take longer for him to pee, and sometimes the stream can be intermittent. Symptoms that are due to the bladder arise because of changes that happen in the bladder wall. As you can imagine, every pee that a man does day in, day out, over the course of several years, if there is increasing outlet resistance, the pressure that the bladder needs to generate to try and force urine out beyond that obstruction needs to increase. So for every pee over a long period of time trying to generate more pressure to expel urine from the bladder results in increased deposition of muscle fiber, or development of the bladder wall muscle, which is called the detrusor muscle. And that muscle actually gets thicker with time. And as it gets progressively thicker, the bladder wall loses its elasticity and therefore loses its compliance. What that means in essence is, instead of being a big elastic floppy bag, the bladder then becomes stiffer and more rigid. What happens in that situation is that a man's perception of fullness happens at a lower capacity. An urgency can get severe enough to the point where men race or rush to the toilet and they get caught short. They don't make it to the toilet in time and they leak urine before they actually make it there. Same thing can happen at night, and that's called nocturia. And nocturia is the situation where men need to get up multiple times at night to go and pee. By and large, when I'm talking to men about their urinary symptoms, the thing that causes them the biggest bother relates to bladder dysfunction. The need to get up multiple times at night, or alternatively to rush to the toilet in the day. So there you have it. To summarize with BPH, it's a very common condition that increases in frequency as men progress through life. It is a benign enlargement of the prostate, a non-cancerous enlargement, but so treatment choices for the management of this condition really relate to quality of life and the degree of inconvenience that a man perceives related to his voiding function. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please give it a thumbs up if you have. Don't forget to subscribe and please switch on your notifications so you stay up to date with all new videos from the Prostate Clinic. Thanks again.